Hey, y'all. That's right, I'm out in the shed. Nobody's more surprised than I am. I get a lot of questions, both online and in person, as a matter of fact, on how I make sure my material that I'm going to be carving on my CNC table is square to the table, and specifically how I know it's aligned with the X-axis travel. To do that, I use this little jig here. It's one of the first jigs that I made for my Gatton CNC when I got it finished. But it's a very simple project that can be made with scrap plywood, scrap MDF. I probably wouldn't use solid wood, but it'll only take an hour or so to build. There are no drastically important measurements. There's nothing specific in here. It's just a quick, simple alignment jig that you can use to mount to the T-track on your CNC table to make absolutely certain that your material is square to the table. So, if you want to see how I made it, stick around. Now, those of you who followed my Gatton CNC build here on YouTube will recognize this as the piece that went in here on the front edge of my table that I cut out to build the mount for my rotary axis. I saved this piece with this project specifically in mind. This is a piece of MDO board, and what it is it's soft wood plywood that is uncovered on one side, and the other side has this resin impregnated brown paper coating. Now, you don't have to use MDO board for this. This is what I had, and I've decided to use it for this jig. The other thing that I'm going to use is a piece of birch FAS cabinet grade plywood and a couple of quarter 20 by inch and a half bolts with just flat washers and wing nuts for right now. I may upgrade these to star knobs, whether I make them or buy them, I'm not sure yet. What I need to do is go out on the table saw. I'm going to use this factory edge to trim this edge down, then use this freshly trimmed edge to trim this edge down to give me the width of the jig that I'm looking for. I'll do the same thing with this piece of birch plywood here. Then I'll cut them both down to length on the miter saw. So let's go outside and get that cutting done right now. With the cutting done, I brought the pieces in here and laid them out on the table, and I've centered this large piece, my stop here, where I'm going to place it, where I want it to fasten down to the table. Then I've placed the stop and just centered it between this end and the other end of my big alignment jig here. And I'm just going to mark the ends. This is on the bottom to help me place it. Then I'm going to flip it over, realign it. Now, I did not flip it front for back. I flipped it end for end, not front to back. Line it up here. Get it set back up. Then I'm going to come along and I'm going to mark areas here, 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 and just go down the line. This is where I'm going to drill and countersink for some number 8 by inch and a quarter wood screws, screwing through the softwood plywood into the hardwood plywood. Now comes about the only real CNC work in this entire process, and that is with my straight edge clamped down and my wing nuts running horizontal here for clearance purposes. I want to bring my CNC over and I want to trim down this front edge so that I'm absolutely certain this bit is running parallel with my Z-axis travel. That way, when I go throw a piece of material up here, I know that the edge is going to be running parallel with the travel of my X-axis, which is the whole purpose of this. Let me also say right here that I did not bother creating a tool path for this. I did nothing in V-carve. What I'm going to do is put on my hearing protection, turn on the router, bring it over here to this corner, and then when it's shaving just an infinitesimal amount off of this corner, I'm going to run it down the whole length. And if I need to do it once or twice because this isn't perfectly square, I'll do so. But I'm not going to bother. This is not worth creating a tool path for. I'm just basically freestyling with my controller. Okay, it's finished, so let's see it in use. Basically, this is a temporary stop to help align material. Off camera, I went and I cut about an inch and a half off of each end of it because I thought it was too big. But the way I'll use it is get my quarter 20 bolt started in my T-track, bring it up here so that this is flush, clamp it down, keeping it pressed firmly against the front of the table. Got it clamped down nice and sturdy. Now, whether I'm using clamps, screws, or my favorite, the CA glue and masking tape method of mounting, I can take my piece of material and put it up here against this stop, fasten it down, then before I even load G-code or start running the CNC, take that off and out of the way. And I know that this piece of material is running parallel to the X-axis travel on my CNC router. Now, if I need to move the piece of material because maybe I've done too much work here and I'm getting screw holes, or I just want this further back, I can come along with another piece of material that I know is parallel on both sides that I've just run over the table saw or something, throw it up against this, throw my piece up here, and no matter what kind of spacer I use between my material and my straight edge, I know that my material is still running parallel with the X-axis travel on my CNC. So that's it. It's a very, very simple alignment jig, a little straight edge that you can use to make absolutely certain your material is aligned with your X-axis whenever you mount a piece of material to your CNC table. Now, I purposely did not give any dimensions to any of this because no two machines are exactly the same. Your T-track may be spaced further apart. It may be closer together. You may have a wider machine than I have. You may have a narrower machine than I have. Basically put, my holes for these quarter 20 bolts are about an inch back from the front edge just to give me some clearance for that last machining move with the CNC when I straightened this up. No, I did not use glue. The reason for that is this piece of MDO has a finish on it. I didn't feel like sanding the finish off. It's not critical. If you want to glue it together, you certainly can. In fact, it might actually be a good idea. So, there's no materials list. There's no specific measurements. It's simply made with scrap materials, whatever you have laying around. If you want to use MDF, use MDF. If you want to use plywood, use plywood. It's 100% up to you. So, Why did I make it? Well, that dovetails into next week's video. I have a project that I'm going to show you on VCarve Pro. Then we're going to come out here and I'm going to actually cut it. And this is going to come in extremely handy because it's a long, narrow piece and I want to make absolutely certain that I get this lined up. So, I hope you got something out of this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. And if you want to follow along with some of my other CNC adventures or check in with some of my Vectric software tutorials, I do hope you'll subscribe to my channel. Now, I put a playlist in the description below of all of the videos in my CNC for Absolute Beginner series and the four-part V-carving for the Absolute Beginner series. So you can check the description box below for that. I've also put links in the description box below to the tools that I used in this video. Some of them may be affiliate links, some of them are not. So it's just there to show you exactly what I use. Thanks for sticking with me. I really do appreciate it. Bye, y'all.